Hello friends, in this video we are going to see the application of Kirchhoff's current law to a circuit, and let's develop a technique called as nodal analysis. Let's take a simple circuit. Let's have generalized value. And suppose we have to get a current flowing through the branches where resistances are connected, meaning current flowing through R1, current flowing through R2 using nodal analysis. One thing is very much important in this is to identify how many nodes are there. So for nodal analysis, to solve a problem, node means a point where more than two branches are connected. So I repeat, node is a point or a junction where more than two branches are connected. So I cannot consider this as a node for nodal analysis because 1 and 2. Branch means number of elements present between two nodes. So I can say this is also a branch because element is present, that is resistance. This is also a branch because element, voltage source, is present. This is also a branch, current source is present. This is a branch where resistance R2 is present. Now here two branches are connected, but here what we are saying, node is nothing but a point where more than two branches are connected. So this cannot be a node for me. This point 1, 2, 3, three branches are connected. Yes, so this will be a significant node. So I will name it as VA. Directly I name a potential of this node is VA. This cannot be a node because two branches, rather this cannot be a branch for me because it's just a wire, just a line. There is no element present between these two points, so I cannot consider this as a branch. So here I have only one branch, that is R2, till this point. And at this point I am having 1, 2, 3 branches connected. So this is also another significant node. So I will mention it as VB. Once you identify how many nodes are there, one node you have to take as a reference. Reference means I will take voltage of that node is 0. So in this particular circuit I got two nodes. One of the nodes I have to take as a reference, so I will take this node as a reference, means the potential of that node I will take as 0. So I will have only one significant node. So I have to get a voltage of that node which I have not taken as a reference. So here I have to calculate voltage of node which is other than a reference. In this problem it is VA, and once VA is known, I can get all the branch currents. How to get branch currents? For this purpose, let's have three simple techniques. So technique number one, if branch consists of a current source, then simply the value of this current source, which I will take as say I, which will be branch current between point A and B. So I will mention here points A and B where current source is present. So I can say current flowing through the branch IAB is I. Second, suppose there is a resistance between two points or two nodes, having the value r. Now the node potential of this A point is VA, node potential of this B is VB, and based on the direction of current that we have chosen, so for example I consider current like this I, which I will mention as IAB from A to B. So I can write an equation, current flowing through this branch is nothing but potential difference between these two points divided by resistance. So potential difference is VA minus VB upon R. See, it depends upon the direction of current, meaning suppose I take a direction like this, which I will mention IPA. So here I have considered B is at higher potential compared to A, so IBA equals VB minus VA divided by R. So based on the direction that we have selected, as per that this equation will change. And third most important rule, suppose I am having a voltage source and a resistance connected in series between nodes A and B. So this is a voltage V, this is the resistance R, and polarity as I mentioned. And suppose I am considering current direction like this, so the equation we will get as, since I have considered current flowing from A to B, so obviously I am considering VA is at higher potential compared to VB. So VA minus VB obviously there, but one more voltage source is there. So in the direction of current, which is A to B, I am having voltage polarity changing plus to minus. So initially it is plus, now it has become minus in the direction of current, so there is voltage drop. So it is minus V divided by total resistance in a branch. Suppose I will consider current direction like this, so I will get an equation IBA equals, now current direction is from B to A, so I assume indirectly B at higher potential compared to A, so VB minus VA, and in the direction of current, which is from B to A, I have voltage polarity changing minus to plus. That means initially it is minus, in a current direction it has become plus. So there is voltage rise. Voltage rise I mentioned as plus. So plus V divided by total resistance in a circuit from B to A, which is R. So keeping these three techniques in mind, we can write the equations for the circuit that we have selected. So let's go back to the circuit once again. So I have this circuit now, where I mentioned a significant node VA, a reference node VB having the potential zero. Let's mark current directions randomly. So I will consider this current source direction as it is. So it is downward. Now here I assume random directions like this. So based on this direction, let's write an equation. Now for this current, it has started from the reference. So from reference to A, current is flowing. So the KCL at node A gives me first current is starting from a reference point, so zero minus, and it is ending on A potential, so 0 minus VA. And in the current direction I have a voltage source, so voltage source changing this polarity minus to plus, or I can say in a direction of current voltage has changed from minus to plus, that means there is a voltage rise. So voltage rise I will consider positive V divided by total resistance from reference to a point, which is R1 in our case. So this is the incoming current I have taken. So I am applying a KCL. So total incoming current is this and total outgoing is given in a circuit. So equal to total outgoing. So for outgoing, I am having one current source directly given of I value. So I will write that as it is. Plus second outgoing current is this. Starting from A potential and ending on reference. So I am assuming A is higher compared to B as far as potentials are concerned. So I can write VA minus 0 divided by resistance in this branch, which is R2. So here I am having only one unknown potential, that is VA. So I will rewrite the terms. V by R1 will be the fixed, minus I again a fixed, and I can take to this side, equals VA upon R2 plus VA upon R1. So this term I will get as a fixed value. VA is the only unknown, 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R1 is also fixed. So from this I can get value for VA. Once a potential of a node is obtained, I can get any branch current, meaning current flowing through R1 I can get as 0 minus VA plus V divided by R1, because this was a term which was telling it is a current flowing through R1. So substituting the value of VA, I can get IR1. Similarly, substituting the value of VA in this equation or in this term, I will get VA minus 0 divided by R2. If I substitute VA, I will get IR2. So here we have seen that nodal analysis is a technique where we are supposed to get node voltages, and from the node voltages we can get branch currents. Whereas in terms of a mesh analysis, we used to get loop currents, and from loop currents we used to calculate all the branch currents. So that is the difference between mesh analysis and nodal analysis. In subsequent videos, we will see how to apply nodal analysis. Thank you.